My name is Solomon Mabuza, here in Buffelspruit village, which is Andangoma's local municipality, Mpumalanga province. I'm the chairperson of this project. The name of the project is Silwanendlala Ubuntu, Farmers Cooperative Limited. Okay. We started this project in 1986, where I realized that the majority of people, they are not working. They were retrenched from the different companies.
The land that you are occupying, what's the size of it?
The land is 83 hectares.
Okay.
But 11 hectares is already have a water pipes for irrigating.
And you have been part of your project has been part of the South African Institute for Entrepreneurship AgriPlanner program, right?
Yes.
And you yourself was even part. You were even part of the training that was conducted initially.
Yes.
Now, what benefits do you think that as a project you guys have actually derived from that program?
We benefited a lot, because before we were not have a skill for planning the land. Actually, when we want to plant something, and the training assisted us on planning the land, because when we go to the buy some seeds, it gives us a plan that how many kgs of seed that can we buy in the so much hectares. So when we come from the workshop, we came and make a very big difference, especially on planting, because we know very well how many kgs of seeds that we can buy for so much hectares. Even to communicate with the market, consumers, it has been very easy when we come from the training.
All right. And then have you, I'm sure you came and not all the members attended, but have you been able to impact some knowledge onto other members?
Yes, I referred the skill to another member, to other members, even to other projects, because we are in a rural areas. Other people, they are trying, but they don't have some skills for doing. But I try to meet even those people to provide them with the skills.
Okay, and then when it comes to you're saying that the program has helped you to organize yourselves properly in terms of production and as well as market. Do you see any changes in terms of, apart from production, do you see any changes in terms of sales? If you're saying that you're now able to connect with the market, to what extent have you benefited from the market since that time?
We have benefited a lot. As I said before, that now it's easy for us to communicate with the market and with something which is available in the farm. Because that time we were talking just we gonna plant sometime a cabbage or what, but we don't know how many of them in a hectare, how many seeds that we can put in a hectare. That is going to qualify to the market. We're just planting, but since we received the training, it's easy for us. Let me make an example with the tomatoes. In a 1 hectare, we know that when we put two lines, it makes 41,000 plants. All of this knowledge, We get it from the training and many more.
I mean, what challenges are you currently faced with? I mean,
Yes, the very big challenge that we have now, that we face now, it's a pack house.
You mean you need a pack house?
We need a pack house.
Okay.
It's a pack house, and to repairing the dam, because we got a dam here, a water dam storage. So in our dam, the dam was damaged by the heavy rains long years ago. So if we can fix this dam, we can have a lot of water for irrigating our plants, which means it's a pack house dam and a workshop, because our tools now it's outside, as you see there, our outside it's outside, and it's too difficult to work outside during the rain days. You can't do anything. So is there something that we need now, that we need now? As I said, it's a water dam, a renovating of a water dam storage, a pack house, and a workshop, and the market. We're still communicating with the market. There is a local market here, and we want to also join the commercial market, and we have got supermarkets like Score, Spa, and Kruger National Park.
You supply them right now?
No, not yet. We're communicating with them.
Okay.
Even the Swaziland need a lot of things in our farm, and the Mozambique. I think last year I was in Mozambique to communicate with them. They want many tomatoes and cabbage, and also Swaziland, they want those things. Tomatoes, green pepper, hot pepper, and many more. So that is why now we are preparing land. We try to meet those things, or want to try to supply them with those things that they want. In our project here, we're also assisting the school, primary and secondary schools.
You mean like the one on this side here? One cannot see it properly.
Yes.
But okay, yeah.
Yes, the school children, they are coming here and learn how to plant the plant, how to maintain the plant, and how to irrigate, even the pest control, even to use water, the watering the plants. We're also teaching them. And the other teachers, they come here without children and take that knowledge of doing that.
Practicals.
Yeah, practicals.
Okay. Do you have any intention of showing them AgriPlanner, or you've done that already?
No. Yes, we showed them.
You showed them AgriPlanner?
Yes.
Okay. Because I see you got a kit.
Yes.
Got AgriPlanner kit and some workbooks.
Yes, because they've got some gardens in the schools.
Okay.
So we've got a books here that we get from the during the training.
Okay.
So we teach them as the book says.
Okay.
So we teach them how to plan your garden. It can be small or bigger one, yeah. But to plan how are you going to plant? It's very much important we teach them.
And how many schools are you involved in now? Would you say you are involved in?
The schools here, it's five schools.
Five schools, okay.
Yeah, two secondary.
Okay.
And three primary.
No, that's fine. That's good work.
And other one that is coming from other side.
Yeah.
Not in our village, around Komazi, and another region. They come and make some practicals here. Even as I'm talking now, there is a student which is coming from the agricultural college to make a practicals here.
Oh, that's super. That's super. Thanks, Mr. Mabuza.
Thank you
very much. Thank you. Yeah. Thank you. What are you going to plant here, and do you have a market for this? Just two questions.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, at the moment, we have got a market of this. Because we have.
What are you going to plant there?
We are going to plant tobacco, banana, and green meals, vegetables. We pushed by the another market from Joburg. Other guys from of the Indian guys, they come here every time. They said, "Please, guys, we want this kind of vegetables." So we said now, because we've got some tractors for doing the job, let's do it. But we have to sign the contract. Everything now is prepared. I think sooner than later we have to sign the contract. We'll call them and come and see how we have prepared our place.
Okay, so you haven't planted anything here yet?
No.
You're waiting for the contract to be signed first?
Yes,
okay.
Because we can't put anything without signing the contract.
Okay. Mr. Mabuza, just one last question.
Yes.
If you have a request that you want to put to the South African Institute for Entrepreneurship and its funders, since we also part of your project, what will you say is your most needy? Or in other words, the very thing that you want us to help you with?
Yeah, something which is in the first priority on our needs.
Mm.
It's a water, because we can't do anything without water.
You mean the dam?
Yeah, the dam.
Okay, the repairing of the dam, right?
The renovation of the dam.
Okay, renovation of the dam. Have you done any costing on it yet? How much do you think it will cost?
I think it's not much more money that can.
But just an estimate.
I think plus or minus 300,000, because it needs the machine for digging a soil and making a wall,
okay.
A dam wall,
okay.
And the roller machine, okay. Just to make a dam strong.
Okay.
And another thing, it's a pack house.
Okay.
The market.
Okay.
Yeah, we need an assistant, because when we plant something here, we must have a market which can buy, because we are working for money.
Yeah.
And to make it all right, it will create even the job in our community, because our aim and objective of this project is to create job for the community, is to fight against hunger and poverty, and reduced the crime in the community.
Thank you very much, Mr. Mabuza.